The Congress on Saturday alleged that the Prime Minister and Amit Shah are responsible for the sorry state of the governance in the state, and that the dissenter was ruling the state though some unknown and faceless persons with the help of the bureaucracy. AICC media in charge Randeep Singh Surjewala said that the Congress wants a special session to be convened immediately. Here's the story in detail.
The Chief Minister Manohar Parrikar has been sick for the past 7 months and so months diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. For a part of those months, he has been out of the state for treatment. He was also brought from the AIIMS to his residence on a stretcher. After that, he was been at home, where he had been a cabinet meeting at his residence.
The national leadership of BJP, led by Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi and Shri Amit Shah, and I am leveling a very serious charge with a sense of responsibility, is holding the progress of Goa, the constitutional government in Goa, and the democratic setup of Goa to ransom by running it through faceless shenanigans, having been sent in the corridors of power, who are looting the resources of the state with the active complicity of Delhi by denying appropriate medical treatment and attention to Chief Minister Shri Manohar Parrikar and by ruling in his name. The responsibility starts with the Prime Minister of India and the BJP National President Amit Shah and goes all the way down to the bureaucrats. Everybody is a party to the plunder of state's resources. And that's why a special session and holding the government accountable to the legislature elected by people of Goa is the only single way forward. Shenanigans of BJP want to rule through a mukota and want to usurp the state's resources. So the unelected, unknown, unseen faces are running Goa and deciding things.
Surjewala has asked why no medical bulletins have been released by the doctors. He asked if BJP leaders are doctors. He called the formulation of CAC as a fraud on the constitution.
On account of incapacity of the Chief Minister, owing to his illness, power brokers are running amok, plundering the state's resources and holding democracy to ransom in Goa. On 31st October 2018, official Twitter handle of Goa Chief Minister posted a picture of a cabinet meeting. I have again sort of attached it as a soft copy to you, although you are well aware. People of Goa, as also elsewhere, were deeply disturbed by the visual in the picture. It reflects that Shri Parrikar needs emergent medical attention rather than the grandstanding being done by BJP vis-a-vis his health for clinging to power in some fashion. Goa is suffering from a complete breakdown of constitutional machinery. Democracy has become defunct and people's mandate has been stolen by BJP's national leadership led by Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi and BJP President Shri Amit Shah. State BJP President Mr. Vijay Tendulkar himself admitted that the government has lost majority. However, BJP President Shri Amit Shah disregarded democratic mandate and is holding governance and democracy and constitution to ransom by insisting that there will be no change of leadership in Goa. The truth is, paralyzed governance, crippled administration is an inflicted wound that BJP has caused on the state. And I have 6 or 7 pointers for in that light. Number one, why hasn't a single health bulletin been issued by doctor on the health of the Chief Minister of Goa, Shri Manohar Parrikar, till today? Are bureaucrats or BJP leaders doctors? That they are speaking and not the doctors. Number two, If Chief Minister is fine, as BJP seems to claim, why is he refusing to meet the leader of opposition, our legislators and the people at large and interact with them? Is he not Chief Minister of the entire state? Constitution is being held captive by BJP's lust for power. Formation of a cabinet advisory committee by the BJP is a blatant fraud on the Constitution of India. It negates the constitutionally conferred powers of the cabinet, which are conferred by Article 163, 164 and 166 of Constitution of India, which does not envisage any body above the cabinet of the state. Fourthly, the statements of cabinet ministers, BJP leaders and their allies reflect a complete disintegration of rule of law, collapse of authority, paralysis of governance and crippling of administration. Shri Narendra Modi and Shri Amit Shah are squarely responsible for the same.
A video joins Viraj Kamath from Panaji.